bringing up several points. He thinks that Bill is more or less able to maintain his cut point, but in the course of the day, his fatigue may lead to him dropping to a lower RSC curve. All these are real-world points. I want to complement this with something. It's C-O-M-P-L-E. Bill and I always have this argument. Harold Kandel, experts in our field, one of the fathers of all this work that we do, he always points out, he does chest radiography. He says, I see a ditzel on a chest film. It's from a college kid. Never smoked, healthy person. I say, go away, come back in a couple years. I see a two-pack-a-day 30-year smoker. I see a ditzel on a film. I say, we need to work you up. That's moving yourself on your RSC curve. That's the real world. And we have had a big argument about that. And to really understand this, you have to know the difference between a likelihood and a posterior probability ratio. And we've had this discussion, and I don't think that if you're not a statistician and you're not involved in this problem, a lot of people get that confused. But I see people agreeing with me. You make a judgment on the fly as to whether this is a high-risk person or not, and you will move your point on the RSC curve, and that's another reason for studying the entire curve.